I'm Andrew Wasson from Creative Guitar Studio. Thanks for joining me for another one of my guitar lessons. This time we're going to be discussing the combination of using minor pentatonic with the Mixolydian mode. It's a very cool sound, and this was suggested as a video topic by Jeff. He's out in Baltimore, Maryland, and he wrote in with this question. He says, I have a question on the combined use of Mixolydian mode with the minor pentatonic in rock and blues phrases. I've noticed that guys like Jimmy Page, Van Halen, and my all-time favorite Michael Schenker use Mixolydian with the minor pentatonic scale quite a lot. Can you maybe run through the music theory for the combined notes of these scales and show some examples on how to use them? From Jeff in Baltimore, Maryland, USA. Well, hey, thanks for writing in, Jeff. Now, before I carry on with this explanation, a good place for us to start is in understanding the blend we have when layering Mixolydian with the minor pentatonic. See, the combined use of these scales allows us to have at our disposal two different third intervals, the major third as well as the minor third. Now, this sound is used extensively in many styles like rock, blues, soul, funk, jazz, and even country and western music. However, since the application of these layered interval sounds with the major and minor third have their roots in blues, it's very important to realize that the swing or shuffle feel will play an important role alongside your initial use, especially in helping you to blend the major and minor third. So to get things started, let's examine a few diagrams of how these two scales overlay their intervals on the guitar neck. Well, before we get into doing the work on the guitar neck where we're going to be combining and overlaying Mixolydian with minor pentatonic, I just wanted to hit this fretboard diagram page here for a moment with you and get you to understand the relationship of the specific notes when you're comparing minor pentatonic scale over to the Mixolydian. And the main thing that we're going to be looking for is either what's different or what's the same, and then of course what kinds of notes are very unique and that we may want to really lean into when we're doing some playing, whether that's writing a melody or doing some improvising. So let's start with one of the most common shapes that we generally get into when we first are understanding more about improvisation on the guitar, and that would be this minor pentatonic shape. Super popular shape here. Now we're off of the root of A at the 6th string and the 5th fret. Now we're just going to look at the notes specifically that we'll have in the A minor pentatonic scale, and they would be of course the tonic note of A moving up to a C natural, then a D, then an E, and then a G note, bringing us back to the octave of A once again. Now, when we go to the guitar fretboard and look at this more closely, you can see here our first movement of the A note up to the C is it's a whole step plus a half step, which is what's referred to as a minor third. Now, when we have a minor third in a scale, it's instantly giving us the color of minor. For instance, if we wanted a major off of this root, we would need a C sharp, not a C natural. So once we do that initial movement off of the root here, we're getting a lot of minor color right away. We're establishing the tonality of the scale. And then we're moving across here to the 5th string at the 5th fret, which is our D. And that interval would be a perfect 4th from the root of A. Then we'd move up a whole step to a perfect 5th, which would be the E note up there on the 7th fret. Then we'd move across over to the 4th guitar string on the 5th fret, which would be a G note. And this is another unique tone, adding a really nice color to this scale, which is the minor 7 tone, the flat 7. And it's a unique tone in comparison as well to your Mixolydian, because it's also found in that Mixolydian mode. So it's kind of a nice tone, which is going to add or allow us to have sort of a link between these two scales because it's a common tone. So hold these notes in your mind, and we're going to move next over to an A Mixolydian mode, and we're going to notice what's similar and what's different between these two scales. Let's do that next. Well, here now you can see we have the Mixolydian mode built again off of our root of A at the 5th fret of our 6th string. And here's the tones that are found in that Mixolydian scale. They are A, B, C sharp, D, E, F sharp, G natural, and then back to the octave of A. So let's first of all begin here with the common tones that are shared between minor pentatonic as well as Mixolydian. And they would of course be here the perfect fourth, the perfect fifth, and the flat seven. These tones are obviously in both scales along with the root and the octave. So the first unique tone I would like to talk about is the second degree here, and this is a B note. Now this major second is a color tone. It's not adding a lot of flavor to things. It's just an extension against the root. And it's not a very unique coloring sound. It's interesting, but it's not going to be as powerful as what we're going to look at next, which is these two over here. These two notes are very interesting to add in. They're going to be great color tones, especially the major third note. If you'll recall when we were doing our discussion about minor pentatonic, we were saying how that C natural in minor pentatonic gave it that minor color. Well, now in the Mixolydian mode, we have a C sharp, which is a major third, making Mixolydian a major tonality scale. Now, what's unique about Mixolydian, however, is it's also got a flat 7. So it's got a major third and a flat 7. Plus, there's the other overlay tone, which is the major 6. It's that F sharp. Now, this is a very cool note to add in. It's one of my favorites to blend in against the flat 7. It creates a very interesting sound when you're improvising or when you're creating melodies, and it can be even be used quite interestingly against that major third as well. So there's some great stuff happening. I just want to flip, though, to one more diagram where we're going to actually get to see the complete overlay, and we'll talk a little bit more about that C natural in the next diagram. So let's flip to that diagram right now. Well, now you can tell we've overlaid both of the scale patterns, and we've got all the notes overlaid here. The notes are given at the lower portion of the screen here. We have the A, B, C natural, C sharp, as well as D, E, F sharp, G, and A. So we have a lot of tones there to mess around with to create melody. But the ones that I would like you to focus on will be the minor third, major third relationship that we have with those Cs, because that's a very unique, interesting thing happening there. And then on the other side here, the F sharp and the G natural, which would be the major 6 and the flat 7 degree. The flat 7 being, again, one of our other minor coloring tones, along with the major third and the minor third there. So all these tones coming together can, when you're focused on them, can really make some interesting things happen when you're composing your melodies and your improvisations on the guitar. So I'll leave you with that, and then the next thing I'd like to do is head over to the actual guitar neck and do a little bit of playing and a little bit of a discussion on the application of all these ideas for your guitar playing. In the initial group of examples I have for you, I'll place my focus upon demonstrating the blending that's possible with the combination of minor pentatonic scale over top of Mixolydian. It's a very cool sound that can work for many different musical situations. And in my final example, I'll have a rock jam that you can practice at home to develop this blending process as well. Now, in example number one, I've put together a great way to start blending these ideas, and it's going to be by simply starting out with a minor pentatonic phrase and ending into a Mixolydian idea. So basically, here's example number one, and the idea starts with a triplet and goes into a series of eighth notes done all under a shuffle feel. Sounds like this. And that's over a dominant seventh A chord. Here it is one more time. Goes right into that flat seven tone, the G note. It's a very cool sound. Now, in my next example, I'll be working through more of a melody line rather than a guitar lick, and this melody leans far more toward the Mixolydian mode and only injects a small melodic phrase from minor pentatonic that's almost barely noticeable to the listener. The melody line leans into the color of, again, A dominant seventh tonality, and the minor pentatonic idea shows up only briefly in measures 3 and 4. Now, to have this melody get across and get its full effect, be sure to really make it swing. So, also, I should mention that in example two here at the beginning of the phrase, it starts on the upbeat of 4 on the first measure. So, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Notice that really strong swing shuffle feel that's there for that phrase. So I'll speed it up again and I'll play it one more time. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, now let's move on to example number three. Here I've set up a longer phrase that weaves back and forth between these scales with a very strong lean toward the minor pentatonic sound. Now, in the appearance of the Mixolydian scale when it's used, it's only done so by way of minimal note selection, primarily through the use of Mixolydian's unique major third tone. Now, in this melodic example, it's going to be phrased up a whole step from where we were. It's going to be on the B dominant seventh tonality. So therefore, the minor pentatonic that we'll apply will be off of the root of B, giving us B minor pentatonic scale. Now, one last thing I should mention is that the lines are predominantly of the 16th note duration, and the phrases in this example will be fairly quick to develop, so take your time learning how to play these phrases accurately. And because this line is kind of dependent on having a good solid backing track behind it, I'm going to do a demonstration of example 3's melody performed with a backing track. In my final example, I've gone and composed a rock progression in the sound of E dominant tonality. Now, the riff that I'll be using applies both E minor pentatonic sounds and as well as the notes of the E Mixolydian mode. So to give you an idea of how this riff is played, I'm just going to jam it out for you here right now. It goes like this. This is the riff for example number 4. It sounds like this. Now, I've also composed a melodic idea that works alongside of this backing track. So I'm going to do some playing for you right now, where I'll start by performing the composed 8-bar melody, and then I'll be improvising for the remainder of the jam track. But to help viewers develop some chops for this progression, I'll have it released on my guitar blog update YouTube channel on April 14th, 2013. When you get a chance to start jamming on this track, be sure to work at applying both the E minor pentatonic as well as that Mixolydian mode sound. So here we go. We're going to jam this thing out right now. Whether you've been improvising for years or if improvisation is something new for you, learning scales is going to be at the top of the list for helping you to establish which notes are good sounding and which notes are perhaps not so good. And with scale practice and the rehearsal of all kinds of fretboard shapes comes with it the study, inevitably, of intervals. Now, the overlay, as we've seen, of two different scale types can generate a good deal of unique sounds, and the way we learn to implement those sounds often comes down to how well we know and understand musical intervals. So whether we want to use more minor and major thirds, or perhaps we enjoy the sounds of a major sixth or a minor seventh, once we know our intervals, we can control how our solos and our melodies interact much better. And hopefully that knowledge will make the music we create sound much better as well. Anyway, thanks for watching and have fun working on these ideas. You can download the handout and the MP3 jam tracks for this video over at my website at andrewwasson.com. And you can follow me on Twitter, through Facebook, and on my other guitar blog YouTube channel. The links are all in the description box below for you. Take care, everybody, and we'll see you next time. Bye for now.